it starts. And I want to play this for you also, Dr. Tobin, and you could tell the ladies and gentlemen of the jury what this informs us.
Dr. Tobin. My stomach hurts. My neck hurts. Everything hurts.
So now he's rocking his right side. You can see how he's moving his hip to try and rock the right side of his body to try and get air. You can see him again pushing down on the street to get air in. And these movements of his hip, you may miss, but he's having to use all his entire spine to just try and get air into that right side of the body. Keep in mind the left side is non-functional from the way they have manipulated him and pushed him into the street. So he's trying, cranking up his right side of his body, you can see it right there, to try and get some air into his right side of his chest. He's making repeated struggling movements. He's moving again the hips because he's using his spine to try and get them, those muscles, to move air into the right side of his chest. And he's again trying to use his right arm, and he's unable because of the chain, the small chain linking it over to the left side. He's trying to have pushed down on that right arm into the street to try and help him, but he's unable to do it because of the chain on the handcuffs.
And at some point, Mr. Floyd stops
as the cessation of respiratory efforts. When he last take a breath, the knee remains on the neck for another 3 minutes and 27 seconds after he takes his last breath. The knee remains. After there's no pulse, the knee remains on the neck for another 2 minutes and 44 seconds after the officers have found themselves. There's no pulse. The knee remains on the neck another 2 minutes, 44 seconds.
Thank you, Dr. Tobin. No further questions.